fellow cinephysiasts. My name is Christina, and welcome to another Let's Get Reelz movie review. Today's movie is actually a request left for me in the comments of my review for Whiskey Tango Foxtrot from Jamie Shea, who has requested that I review The 100-Year-Old Man Who Climbed Out the Window and Disappeared. The movie is very, very funny. It is, as the title says, about a 100-year-old man named Alan Carlson, who I believe lives in like Norway or one of those Scandinavian countries, and he has turned 100 and he's living in a nursing home. He doesn't have any other family. He never married, so he's all alone. He doesn't want to be in the nursing home anymore, so he just decides to climb out the window and go to a different town and go wherever. I don't even think he realizes it. His brain is kind of falling apart. I mean, he is 100 years old. He really kind of doesn't know what he's doing. So he goes to a bus station, and at the bus station, this young guy who you can tell definitely is not up to anything good, he has a suitcase, and he asks Alan to watch over the bag, and Alan winds up taking it. He doesn't even realize he takes it while the guy is going to the bathroom. He just like walks away and gets on the bus, and the bus drops Alan off at this old train depot where this guy lives, and then it's just like one blunder after another for Alan and for this guy. I believe his name is Julius, and the bag actually contains a crap ton of money, and the guy who had left it behind works for, I guess, some kind of criminal, and he's got to get the money there. And really, I mean, when I say it's like a snowball effect of one crazy lunatic thing after another, it is one crazy lunatic thing after another that happens. And throughout the story, Alan, I believe he tells it or he just recalls it, all of the things that he's done throughout his life, which if you have seen A Big Fish or like Amelie, that's kind of what it reminded me like the style of Amelie, and definitely like the storytelling of Big Fish. And who knows if they're real, if they're not, because he did so many crazy things. He worked for like the Soviet Union at one point. He worked in America making bombs, and when he was a kid he liked blowing things up, and his father was like in the early 1900s preaching about contraception when it wasn't really popular, and it was just so nuts. It was just nuts. It was fun to watch. It was really, really silly. And, and if you liked Amelie, if you liked Big Fish, you'll definitely like The 100-Year-Old Man Who Climbed Out the Window and Disappeared. I'm very, very thankful and very happy that Jamie Shea recommended I watch this movie, because it is a little bit different from what I normally watch, and I do love foreign movies, and I like it when movies can be different. I think foreign films definitely have the edge over American films, because to me it's as if they like quality over quantity, if that could be applied here, but they definitely, to me, like quality of their storytelling, the acting. I always find foreign films to have better storytelling and better acting, and even better directing. It depends on, you know, the director here in America, but most of the time for me, the direction is always excellent. The only thing I will say that I did not like about The 100-Year-Old Man Who Climbed Out the Window and Disappeared is that it kept bouncing between English and whatever the language was, Swedish, Norwegian, I'm not exactly sure what country it's from, and I really didn't like that. It kind of like drove me nuts, and there was like a few other languages thrown in there. I don't know, I would just rather have like stuck to one language and that was it, give me the subtitles, instead it like bounced around. I mean, and I guess it being in English helped, like the narration was in English. That was the only thing I really didn't like about this movie, was how much it like flip-flopped between languages, because it just stopped the flow of the storytelling. Well, not really stopped, but it didn't help the flow of the story too much. So that was my review of The 100-Year-Old Man Who Climbed Out the Window and Disappeared. Thank you so much, Jamie, for recommending this. I hope you guys can go and find The 100-Year-Old Man Who Climbed Out the Window and Disappeared. And if you do, leave your comments down below so we can further discuss the movie if you have seen it already. And if you have any suggestions like Jamie Shea, please also leave those in the comments. And as you can see, I will give you a shout out if I pick your movie and I watch it. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button for future movie reviews, because that is what I like to do here. And as always, keep watching movies and stay absolutely fabulous.